Greetings. A lot of my earliest videos were rather bombastic. I did, after all, start out making videos revealing and refuting the lies of Ahmed Deedat. I just found it so purely offensive, the pure lies he told. It made me mad that poor souls in Islam drink his lies without thought. I admit, it still makes me mad at the devil, the father of lies, the Allah of Islam. I'm sure that shocks you, Ali. How can I say that Satan is the Allah of Islam? Well, brother, Jesus said that Satan is the father of lies. And if you examine Islam, honestly, it is spread by lies, brother. But let us look at a very real case where lies are used to spread Islam. This video is about a leader of Islam. A leader of Islam making a wrong statement. A leader of Islam making a false statement. A provably false statement. And using it, a provably false statement, to try and claim Mohammed is mentioned by Jesus. You know, Ali, why that is so important. Mohammed claimed in Surah 7, 157 and 7, 158 that he was foretold. And for 1400 years, no one in Islam has found an actual mention. But there is a leader, Ahmed Deedat, who teaches the following. John 16:13 is a hidden or secret mention of Muhammad. Let us first read John 16:13 together so you know what it actually says. Jesus has mentioned the Comforter and is about to describe what the Comforter will do. This is the King James translation, John 16:13. Howbeit when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth, for he shall not speak of himself. But whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and he will show you things to come. Now let us read it again together, and let us count the male pronouns. Howbeit when he, that's one, the Spirit of truth is come, he, that's two. He will guide you into all truth, for he, that's three. For he shall not speak of himself, himself, that's four. But whatsoever he shall hear, that's five. That shall he speak, that's six. And he, that's seven, will show you things to come. If you notice, that is seven male pronouns. You just counted them with me. Let's do it again. Howbeit when he, that's one, the Spirit of truth is come, he, that's two, will guide you into all truth, for he, that's three, shall not speak of himself, that's four, but whatsoever he, that's five, shall hear, that shall he, that's six, speak, and he, that's seven, will show you things to come. So do you think there is anything special about counting like this? Is this a difficult task? Did it take special education to count to seven? Now, brother, as a Muslim, does eight have any special meaning in Islam? Would this verse be more important if it had eight male pronouns, for example? Is eight the number of prophethood or revelation or holy jihad? I am asking because I wonder what would make somebody intentionally miscount. Wiki says eight in Islam is the number of angels that carry Allah's throne. I found one Islamic numerology site that said eight means mischief, punishment, or disaster. Anyway, brother, I'm getting ahead of myself. You counted them with me, and there are seven male mentions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Did you have trouble counting to seven, brother? Do you think an imam or famous teacher of Islam knows how to count as well as you and I? Well, let's watch as just such a man counts to eight. and the crazy thing he thinks that means. He is using the same King James translation.
Let me reread to you this verse with a little emphasis on the pronouns. He says, I have yet many things to say unto you, but ye cannot bear them now. Howbeit, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak from himself. But what things shall he hear, that shall he speak, and he shall declare unto you the things that are to come. He shall glorify me. 8 masculine pronouns in one verse. I say, it ill befits a ghost. You agree? That is a man, a man, a man, a man. 8 times. There is not another verse in the whole Bible with 8 masculine pronouns or 8 feminine gender or 8 neuter genders. There isn't. This is a unique verse for a unique personality, Muhammad. Man, 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 not a ghost, not a spook.
Note, the video segment says John 16:12. But I am not critiquing a typo or a simple mistake. It uses 8 masculine pronouns, Deedat says. It is a man, a man, a man. Is it a man, a man, a man because the count is 8 times? Didn't you and I already count only 7? 8 times.
And 8 times.
This is unique. These are Deedat's own words. 8 times. Why is Deedat so fixated on 8 having some meaning, brother? Brother, is Deedat some unlearned child who does not know 7 from 8? It is a unique verse for a unique person, Mohammed. The claim is crazy, brother. This is the logic string that Deedat offers as his proof. The verse has 8 masculine pronouns. This makes the verse unique. Therefore, this unique verse must reveal a unique man. Muhammad is the most unique man in history, even though he offers no proof of that. Therefore, this must be Muhammad. As a proof, that is simply nonsense. Garbage. But the real problem is that Deedat lied about the count of 8. There really are only 2 explanations here, brother. Deedat could not read and see the Bible verse indicators, and he created a story that in his excitement, he never checked his idea, his story. Remember, this was a prepared speech, brother. This was Deedat speaking the next night to Muslims after he debated Jimmy Swaggart. This was a prepared teaching to a friendly audience who would never check. Or Deedat made up a story which needed 8 because 8 is somehow special in Islam. And then Deedat lied about the verse to create a count of 8. Again, this was a prepared teaching to a friendly audience who would never check. Since we cannot know Deedat's heart, we can never know which is right. But as it stands, it really does not matter. Deedat's story, his theory, is simply garbage. It stands on a count of 8, and you proved his count was wrong, brother. You counted with me. Remember, brother, this is a perfect example of just how far Islam will go to prove the Quran is not false. But, brother, if after 1400 years this is the best idea Islam has to offer, if after 1400 years no evidence can be found proving Muhammad did not lie in Surah 7, 157 and 158, the situation for Islam is indeed very, very desperate. I pray that God would allow you to desire the truth, brother. And I pray that you would open your heart to his guidance. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.